So we're now here at the Ness of Brodgar on mainland Orkney. Today we've already been to the Stones of Stenness and the Ring of Brodgar, but the Ness of Brodgar is where it's all happening. There's been digs and research going on here since 2003. And today is the day they open the 2017 season. And we're gonna interview the main archaeologist here, have a chat with him about what's been discovered. What fascinates me the most is all these carvings that are found here, as well as even one of the carved stone balls that are found all over Aberdeenshire and Scarra Brae and other places. And so we're gonna ask him a few questions about that and have a look round and have the tour guide give us the latest on this. So this is the 5th of July. It's been open a couple of days. They've just been clearing everything off the site. It's been closed all winter, but today is the first day it's actually open. It's a beautiful day. It's very windy, so I apologize for the sound. And let's see what's going on here. This is one of the most important sites, if not the most important excavation going on in the whole of Europe as we speak. Hello, so I'm just here with Nick Card, and at the Ness of Brodgar dig on the first day it's open in 2017. He's going to give us a brief interview for Megalithomania just about what's going on here, what's being discovered, and what the plans are for this year. So Nick, can you just tell us what's happening here right now?
Well, it's only been 2 days since we opened the site up for this season, so the first few days have been taken up with just removing the winter covers, you know, thousands and thousands of tyres which hold all the tarpaulins and geotextile membrane in place to protect the site from over the winter. So today is the first day we're actually getting down to some proper archaeology, but also most importantly also this is the first day where we're open to the public. You know, the public's perception and integration with what we're doing is very important to what we do here at the Ness. But another great season in prospect. We'll be again looking at some of these amazing structures that have been uncovered, these monumental buildings, really down onto the floor deposits and sampling and trying to understand how these structures were used and changed through time. But also, perhaps most fascinating, is this strange enigmatic structure that appeared in our new trench, Trench T, at the southern end of the site, which seems to incorporate certain construction techniques, including the incorporation of 4 meter long megaliths, which doesn't seem to have parallels anywhere else as far as we know.
So there's actual like megaliths like we find at the stone circles here, what, recumbent for lying down inside that particular area?
In that particular area, they're actually used lengthwise but on edge. So they're not fully recumbent, but they are on edge.
Do you think they were standing?
I think that these stones have been utilised elsewhere before being incorporated into this build, but only when we conduct further excavation can we be sure about how they relate to the stratigraphy and how they relate to the history of the site.
And was it last year you found like one of the sort of Aberdeenshire style stone spheres? Where is that? Was that significant that it's found here?
The stone ball, the carved stone ball, was found, I think it was in 2013. It seems again to be unique to the Ness, that particular configuration of six knobs on this stone ball, the way how they're deliberately asymmetrically placed on the sphere. But most importantly, this stone sphere was found in a secure archaeological context, which, you know, not many carved stone balls have been found in the past.
Okay, so what is the significance, do you think, of the placement here between the Stones of Stenness, the Ring of Brodgar? Was this whole kind of strip of land like a sacred causeway or something like this?
I think during the Neolithic, you know, over the 1500 years of the Neolithic in Orkney, the significance of this place would have changed. But I think when you stand at the Ness and look at the amazing landscape in which it's set, this huge natural amphitheatre that seems to have the Ness at its very core, very hub of it, that it is related to, you know, what is the activity that is happening at the Ring of Brodgar, Stoneziston Ness and Maze Howe. But I think, you know, what we see today is only the tip of this, you know, amazing landscape of not just ritual monuments but also habitation and perhaps new forms of site which we haven't really encountered before.
And there's this idea that this was some kind of, almost like a university, this particular spot we're on now. Have you come across this idea? Has it been discussed, or is that just speculation?
I think that is pure speculation at present. I know there's been several theories put forward about various sites being kind of very special colleges and places in the past, and the most recent obvious choice for this kind of Neolithic university or college of astronomer priests is obviously the Ness, but I must admit that, you know, the evidence is at present lacking into, you know, that interpretation. I think there's a great amount of other possibilities, other interpretations, but no matter what, I think the Ness in its heyday was probably one of the most significant sites in Neolithic Britain.
And a lot of the stones have got like carvings on them, like zigzag carvings and different styles. Has anything been like researched on that, about the origins of that, or any meaning?
There's lots of research. In fact, there's a very good volume that's just been published, the PhD that was done by Antonia Thomas, and that discusses, that's done a full study of all the decorated Neolithic stones that have been found at the Ness, and the way that they've actually been created, and also, you know, they're looking at the locations of them within buildings, and slowly we are beginning to get a better insight into the potential meaning of these stones. But it's not like we're ever going to find the Rosetta Stone, which is going to inform us of their absolute. I think, you know, they obviously meant things to whoever was creating these beautiful abstract designs, but yes, we'll never know for sure, I don't think.
And this has got some similarities to the Nap of Hawa on Papa Westray, which is potentially older, I believe, than this. How does that fit in, if that's an older site and they've got a similar construction style? Would it all have originated on a tiny island there, or is that just, again, speculation?
No, I think the complex story of the development of Neolithic society is still being discussed and still developing. Every new site that's been discovered, we now have dates at the Ness which push it back to 3500, which is not far off what the early dates in the Nap of Hawa, but we have even earlier dates for that than the Neolithic in Orkney.
I know many years ago Alexander Thom was up here measuring the site, taking astronomical readings and measurement systems. He developed, obviously, you know about the megalithic yard and all these ideas. Has there been any measurements taken here that may match anything that Alexander Thom may have found?
There's not been any direct research relating to that. I think that the extent to which Alexander Thom kind of pushed his ideas was maybe a bit too far. I think that, you know, some of the buildings here were set out with particular dimensions in mind, but I don't think it was a standardized measurement across the whole of megalithic Britain or Europe.
Okay, well, thanks so much. With the summer now, next couple of months you're here working away, is there anything you're expecting to uncover, or is it just by, this is like the joy, this is the fun of the archaeology, you just see what happens?
Well, I think there's obviously a project design behind all our work here, but I'm often asked, you know, what you're going to find when. But, you know, that is the joy of archaeology, that you never know what the next trail will. And I think that any project design has to be adaptable enough to take into account what you may or may not find, because always expect the unexpected.
Well, thanks so much for your time.
Pleasure.
Trench T is very, very interesting. As we look inside it, although currently it's covered up with black plastic, tomorrow it's going to start to be uncovered as they excavate more and make the trench larger. But by Saturday or early next week, it's going to be uncovered. And what's so interesting about this is 4 meter long stones have been found within the trench. And so this is amazing. So we're looking at megalithic blocks, standing stones like those at Brodgar and Stennes, recumbent or on their side at least, inside one of the trenches. So this is a really important discovery here at the Ness of Brodgar.
My best guess with this is that it is, as I said, a great big meeting place. People are coming here and then doing whatever they're doing here, and then maybe processing out then to the Standing Stones of Stennis, up to the Ring of Brodgar for a different purpose, across the Maze House, the great big burial mound across the way, and where else, goodness only knows. So when we get carbon dating from this, hopefully we'll get dates out of this and get some idea as to where in the great big sequence of things this happened. So evidence of a bit of a pavement there, another bit of pavement here, and certainly another pavement over there. So some sort of building's going on here, but what it's about, watch this space. That's our site director, that's the man. And the reason I stopped here is, if you remember, I showed you a few little right angles that appeared when they were excavating in 2003. If you look up to the right hand corner there, can you see that beautiful right angle? And there's another one, the matching one on this side, that's exactly it. And if you look at the quality of the stone masonry just in that bit there, on that wall there, that is just exquisite. And what you're looking at here is dry stone walling at its very best. Now, there's no mortar, no cement in any of this. And it's exactly as found. Now, it's not Disney, this is the real deal. This is exactly as found, and the last time anyone else set eye on this, on that particular structure, would have been nearly 5,000 years ago.
So where were these found exactly?
This particular one, the one with the peck marking, I think this was in 10 itself.
In here?
In here, yeah.
Okay.
So we were here.
Relatively similar to that first
section sort of, you were showing. You'll find there are a couple that look like butterflies, and you'll find, but they're all linear. Again, these are just mace heads and axes.